Okay. Hello, ma'am. So, can you please give a brief introduction about yourself and your area of expertise?
Yeah. I'm Manimegle Mohan, Managing Trustee of Sri Sri Shai Educational Trust. We run around 4 institutions, SSVM institutions in Coimbatore and Mettupalayam.
As parents today are going through a lot of confusion regarding which board to choose for their children. So can you suggest any advice to them?
Today's trend, parents, they think that education should be more of a stress-free education. But I will say that today's children, if they don't face stress at any part of their life, how are they going to face the future? So it is that they have to learn. See, during our days, moral stories were there. So through that, we were able to analyze, if we do this mistake, we will overcome the such problems. So that's how we went in. Today's trend, everything they learn through technology. And there is nobody to say that this is how it has to happen. So this conference, the moment I got the information, such a conference is happening, I was really happy. So I've come all the way from Tamil Nadu to Hyderabad for the sake, expecting something good you all will be giving us, and we can take that and we can put it out to our parents and make them understand of what is the present trend to go with.
Definitely, ma'am. Thank you so much. And it was a pleasure talking to you. Hello, ma'am. Can you please give a brief introduction about yourself and your area of expertise?
Okay. I'm Girija. I'm a nurturing consultant in child development. I was into teaching field earlier as a teacher, and I had the opportunity of teaching children from playgroup till 12th standard, various curricular streams. So there was a time when I had to be on my own and think about how I could contribute to the educational field. So it became my passion to help the children, parents, in bringing up children. So I authored a book titled The Magic of Parenting. It's published by Notion Press, and it's up on sale online. The Magic of Parenting helps in goal-oriented communication. It helps parents as well as educators too, because the educators also are parents, right? So when we communicate with children, usually what parents or educators do is to speak in a problem-centric manner. So the focus is more on problems. So everybody might see, oh, there's a problem. Instead, what as educators, as professionals, and knowledgeable parents, what elders should do is to focus on the solution. And that is our goal, what we need to do. So when we speak goal-centric, what we get is ideas. Instead of a negative feeling that there is a problem, there will be a positive aura that we have goal. We have goals to achieve. And when we think that we need, we have goals to achieve, we start thinking in a very positive manner. Okay, what ideas could reach the goals? How can we achieve this? What can we do? So we become very enthusiastic. So this book is about all positive communication, helps a lot in harmony while bringing up children. And I wrote it specially for the young parents to empower them, to make them feel that it's not at all difficult to bring up children. And I also write blogs, and I've written more than 200 blogs, and I hold workshops, about 20 or 25 workshops I held for parents and young educators at various schools. This is my background.
Ma'am, you were telling about goal-centric education should be indulged. So can you just share a practical example of how a problem-centric education is being shared and how it should be shifted to a goal-centric one? Any simple example?
Okay. At preschool level, this goal-centric communication in the magic of parenting. It is very effective up to 10 or 12 years old. And once the children keep listening to the goal-centric communication, their orientation of problem-solving skills will become better. So one example is at preschool level, some children, they write slow. So if we speak, if we tell them, you're writing very slowly, then where is the focus? On writing slowly, right? That is problem-centric way of speaking. We know that. So the educator, when an educator observes that a child is writing slowly or lost somewhere, what the educator exactly should speak is, it'll be great if you write fast. It'll be nice if you can try to write faster. So, yes. So our goal is to make the child write slightly faster, not to be too slow or lag behind in the class. So that is goal-centric communication. And in the book, several of my experiences also are listed. And to change any habit, we need some help, right? So goal-centric communication is helped by a four circles tool. In the magic of parenting, I created a four circles tool. So all the communication, everything that we speak with children, everything that is there existing in a child's life, from personal to social, all this conversation is included in four circles. 1, 2, 3, 4 circles. And at preschool level, how children respond to the first circle. That is, I called it I circle, I sentences, then you, then he, she, they, it, that, we, us. And then finally, a whole lot of creative aspects also. So it's a wonderful book that helps all the young parents for a positive parenting and stress-free upbringing of children. And children will have a great childhood too.
So thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing about your book. It's a wonderful book. Definitely will request the parents to have it and use it. And thank you very much. It was great talking to you. Thank you, ma'am.
I would like to thank Kausar too, who is representing a management committee of ECA Telangana. And because of her, I'm here as an invitee. And thanks to you all.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So, ma'am, can you please tell a brief about how you went from starting your...